Hello there, doll lovers. Alright, so everybody's been able to find these and been posting pictures on Instagram, Facebook, and all their other doll sites, and I have not. Not in my neighborhood. So I don't know if it's just because my Walmart is gonna get any, or if they're late. I'm not exactly sure what the issue is. But everybody else has been getting theirs. So while I was in Muskogee this weekend, I was visiting family. We had to go take a trip up to Walmart anyway to get a few things. And I decided I'm just going to press my luck, see if this Walmart has them. Lo and behold, they did. They also had several of the Hello Kitty fashion ones, and the double packs, and even one of the accessory packs, which was like a school spirit theme kind of one. So here I am, just like, oh my god. You know, I was happy, but I was also still a little upset because my Walmart hasn't gotten any. And frankly, I don't even know if they are gonna get them. So my husband knows how much I've been trying to find these things, which is why I insist on going to certain stores at certain times. And we just haven't had, you know, the luck of being able to. So we went and price checked, and we were able to find Sparkle Girls outfits too. And my Walmart, there are never any Sparkle Girls outfits. People are always ripping them off of the cardboard. I end up finding, you know, one or two that might be, you know, left, but it's still just, it's just terrible. So they had Sparkle Girl outfits, and they had the Barbie ones, and they even had some of the old Fashionistas. I'm talking when they first introduced Curvy, they had the blonde and the blue haired one. I was like, whoa, if only they had, you know, the Vava Violet one or LA Girl, I would have gone mad over that. I want to still get those too at some point. Seems like everybody's got an LA Girl except for me. So, I bought these last night, but I was not able to take them out and everything. We were just exhausted from our drive. So I'm going to see if this Ken outfit will fit on my World Peacekeeper guy that I just got. And if not, it's not the end of the world because he has clothes that will fit, but I just want to see how well. And I saw Sunny and Lola's review of the fashion pack, and they also got the other one, which was a tank top with sweats. I really feel like this hoodie should have been with the sweatpants, and that the tank top should have been with the shorts. That's just me, because, you know, if it's cold enough to wear a hoodie, you're usually going to be wearing pants. If you're wearing a tank top, you probably might going to have shorts on with it. That's just, you know, normal kind of thing. So let's see how the shorts are. They have an elastic waist. It's a nice, good olive green, so it's not a neon bright color. It's nothing that's going to stand out where anyone can say, oh, that's too feminine or whatever. So we're just gonna slide that on, and it's just always hard to find good size pants to fit, so that's really good right there. And it actually looks good with him because looks like he could still be working out because he's army guy. All right, I don't think, you know what, I can already tell. Just because of the width of my finger, there's like no give that this hoodie's not gonna fit these muscled arms or go through those hands. But that's okay. Alright. I have a tall fashionista here that I actually want to try these outfits on. And we're gonna see how well she's gonna look with the shorts. Awesome. And since they're cutoffs, it doesn't matter, you know, how short they come up on the leg, because they're cutoffs. We cut them at the length we want them. or where the big tear is. Oh, I hate when that happens to a good old nice pair of pants. You get this one rip and your mom's like, oh, gotta turn them into shorts. And you're like, no! Yeah. Alright. Oh, hold on. Apparently you gotta try to get the hood on first before you Velcro. Okay. It'd be nice, though, if these would stop Velcroing in the back all the time and could actually just be stretchy to just fit over the head or, you know, open in the front. It actually looks pretty good on her. If we tuck her hair into the hood, which causes a bit of a mess, but that's fine. Doesn't look that bad. Alright, but I am gonna test out his shoes. So these got, I don't know, some sort of like crocodile skin kind of texture, kind of bubbly. Let's see if they can fit Peacekeeper feet. And from the looks of it, these don't have any indicators of left and right. They are split in the back. Oh, wow. Hey, we have a winner. Some of the other Ken shoes I had couldn't do this. Awesome. So it's not a complete loss. He can still wear the shorts and he can wear the shoes, which is like pretty much the most important part for me because he's got the shirt that he came with and that red one that I found that was able to fit him. Alright, so of all the fashion packs that they had, I decided to go with the one that they only had one of, which is the gray shirt with the white sleeves and the rainbow skirt. I don't know how popular it's going to be, but it was one that I really wanted when I first saw the promo pictures being posted. And I knew I wanted to pair up the rainbow skirt with my unicorn shirt, which I've already seen people do, so it's like, yeah. So we've got like this regular gray t-shirt, but the sleeves have like this white pleather texture to them, which is the texture that matches this skirt. So I brought my doll Shengua over here to see how well it'll pair up with that, because I know these clothes will look good with the other things that I have in mind, but I want to see how well it'll pair with that skirt. Tell you the truth, I can't quite remember. Oh, that's right. This skirt was part of a fashion pack that was out like last year, and my uncle grabbed a handful of them and gave them to me for my birthday. So. But they were like slightly out of season, so I was like, it's still cool. Alright, so I think this actually works really well. The skirt has a slight texture pattern to it, but if you're far enough away, it doesn't even, you can't even tell. But I think with these sleeves, pairing it up with this skirt really works. I think it was a hot pink and orange mesh top. That's what came with this. Alright, so now I want to try this outfit on the tall. I don't have any curvy fashionistas just yet, so I know if it fits the tall, it'll look good on the normal and the petite. Alright. The skirt, thankfully, is elastic, and so it just slides right up. The other skirt, though, it has Velcro in the back. It's a bit more stiff. Now, the only thing is that this fashion pack doesn't come with any shoes. But I have seen pictures of the previous shoe set that we have that's just reboxed in the same type of packaging as all this. Alright, so there we go. It's just above the knee length. So it's still good, but I mean, I would like for her to have underwear if she's going to sit. And then we can pair it with the love necklace. But I mean, with it being gray and the shirt being gray, that's not exactly the best combination. So I might paint the letters that say love. This is a very tiny, thin lavender purse. It has molded on details, but the details would be better showing if they were painted. Since she has straight arms, she's not going to be able to hold it, but if, you know, put on it like a smaller doll or something, it looks okay, but this purse is like really tiny. I would give it more to a Stacy or Skipper character size doll, something smaller, like a teenager. But the necklace is also very cute.